Today, shall we quickly go into prayer before we go to the word of the Lord? Because today is going to be another transforming day. It's a day of transformation. It's a day of glory. It's a day of higher height. It's a day of upliftment. I just want us to quickly go into prayer as we trust God today for His miracle, for His blessing. Because Jesus said, men ought always to pray and not to faint. In other words, prayer must continue without ceasing. You must not waver or quiver. You must not give up. When you are a man of prayer, there is bound to always be a solution. Can we just quickly pray, all my viewer, as you are watching me? You know, we want to put everything in God's hand today, that God will have His way. The word of God will have His full course in your life. Just bow your head wherever place you are right now as we pray to the Father in heaven. Lord, we thank you. You are the great and the mighty one. You are our God, you are our creator. Lord, we come before you today, O God, to be blessed. We come before you today, O God, to be transformed. Not just only to be the hearer, but also to be the doer. Lord, your word is powerful. Your word is a spirit and your word is life. As Jesus said, the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are what? They are life. Lord, we need life to be transformed today. We need, oh God, we need upliftment. We need souls to be blessed. We need something great to happen. Lord, let there be a transformation. Let life never be the same again. Lord, as we go into the in-depth of your word, let your word give us light. Let there be life. Let there be understanding. We ask the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit, of whom I am and of whom I serve, to take control right now and to move, yes, to do great things in the life of people. Do that, O Lord, which no man can do. Move in the life of your children. Anyone sick, O God, let their life never be the same. Anyone that is bruised, that is down, Lord, let power of resurrection come upon their life. We thank you. Thank you, Lord. I ask, Holy Spirit, that you anoint my tongue. Let every word that I speak today, let it bring life to your people, to your children. Because when it comes to your power, distance is not a barrier. Everyone watching me all over the world, I ask right now, the power of God will meet you where you are, and your life will never be the same. I pray for the grace of God that can turn a prostitute to become a preacher of the gospel. I pray for the grace of God that can turn a sinner to become a saint. I pray for the grace of God that can turn even a nobody to become somebody. Today, may that same grace of God, as you are going to hear the word of God today, that grace will turn you from nobody to somebody, to the glory of His name. We pray against obstacles. We ban distraction, O Lord. Lord, have your way. And let your word have its full course. In the name of Jesus, amen and amen. Hallelujah. Today, we are going to dwell on a topic which I have titled, There is a Seed of Solution in Every of Your Problem. Problem of life is real. There is nobody on the planet Earth that doesn't have one or two challenges he or she is going through. As long as there is life, as long as there is breath in you, there must be one challenge or the other that you will go through or you will face. If even you are not going to go through it, they will come and meet you. That is the irony of life. Because life has been designed in such a way that either you are fighting something or something is fighting you. They say what it takes for evil to prevail is for good people to do nothing. It's for good people to do nothing. There must be something that you and I are expected to do for things to work out. Because God created the heavens and the earth, He created the whole world, and God gave the authority, He gave it to one man, which is Adam. And He said, the earth has been given to you. He said, now you should dress the garden and keep it. So God so much trusted Adam, He gave him the key of everything to take over, to oversee, to become a steward of. But I want you to understand today that in life, there are so many things that are all about life. Life at times is not just bed of roses. Life at times is not just the way you think about it. Life is very deep. When people are saying this world is very deep, it's not talking about earth, it's talking about we human beings, you and I. You know, even the animal, the wild animals, like lion, like tiger, like elephant, and so on and so forth, when they are offended, they don't keep their anger. They come against you at once. They fight you. The lion roar and the attack. But human being, it can be so be offended in you, it can plan your demands, it can plan your destruction, it will still be laughing with you. That's why they say life is very, very deep. But I want you to understand that God created you and He has a purpose for your life. No matter what is happening on the planet Earth, there are still what we call the remnant. There are still the seed of God. There are still people who will still survive this end time storm by the grace of God. A lot of things has happened. Many water has passed under the bridge. But we thank God. David said, it was very good for me to go through affliction. Because there is nothing wrong for you to go through something. But what is wrong is, when after being through, or you have gone through something, you didn't come out with any experience. You didn't come out with any substance. The Bible said the children of Israel, they left Egypt with great substance. So, I want you to dare to believe today that you are needed here on earth. You are here for a purpose. The earth needs you. That is why you are still alive. And there is a purpose, and that purpose must be fulfilled. This will lead me to the story of a man called Samson. Every one of us, we have heard about the story of Samson, how the mother and the father waited for a long time before Samson came. Then, the mother, they were in the field, and his father. While they were in the field, the Bible says an angel appeared to the mother of Samson. Samson was not yet born. And the angel told the mother, he said, the child that is about to come is going to be an heavy duty child. It's not going to be an ordinary child, it's a great child. That was why there was delay in your childbirth, in giving birth to a child. Because God was taking His time to prepare every male child to send to this world a child with a purpose, a child with an assignment, a child that is destined to turn things around. He said that child is coming, and these children of such, of this nature, of this caliber, they don't just come like that. They come once in a century. So, it took Samson's mother that this great child was coming. You are going to be pregnant, you give birth to a great child. So, to cut the long story short, the mother accepted, she believed what the angel told her. And he also gave her condition, because when God is going to do something for you, you know, there are roles that is expected of you to also play. That is why we go to 1 Corinthians 12. The Bible will list the 9 gifts of the Spirit. It talks about the word of knowledge, the word of wisdom, the discerning of spirit. It talks about the gift of prophecy. It talks about diverse kind of tongue. It talks about interpretation of tongue. Then it talks about the gift of faith, the gift of healing, and the gift of workings of miracles. Which means Miracles are supposed to be worked out. When one miracle to happen, you have a role to also play. Miracles don't just happen in a place it's not expected to happen. Miracles don't just happen because you want to happen. Miracles happen for a divine reasons and a purpose. So miracle is something that is awesome, that you and I cannot do, or you and I could not even give explanation to, and God does it. It's a miracle. You can see it, I can see it. So this child came finally, and he came as a warrior. He came to possess his possession. He came to do the will of the Father. He came to set the captives free. He came to set at liberty those that are bruised, those that are lampooned, those that are lambasted. That was the mission of Samson on earth. Now, in Judges 14, look at the story here that I want to quickly go into. Judges 14, verse 1. The Bible says, "And Samson went down to Timnath and saw a woman in Timnath of the daughters of the Philistines. And he came up and told his father and his mother and said, 'I have seen a woman in Timnath of the daughter of the Philistines. Now therefore, get her for me to wife.' Then his father and his mother said unto him, 'Is there never a woman among the daughters of thy brethren, or among the people, that thou goest to take a wife of the uncircumcised Philistines?' And Samson said unto his father, 'Get her for me, for she pleased me well.'" Verse 4. "And his father and his mother knew not that it was of the Lord that he sought an occasion against the Philistines. For at that time, the Philistines had dominion over Israel." Every dominion of the enemy over your life today is broken. You are taking over. The table is turning for your good. Power is changing hand. "As at that time, the Philistines had dominion over Israel. No more so anymore. That you serve God, you still live like a slave or a servant. You praise God, you pray, you live an holy life. You love God so much, and things are not going well. It's not going to be so again. Things are turning for your favor and for your good." So, in verse 4 again, "And his father and his mother knew not that it was of the Lord that he sought an occasion against the Philistine, for at that time, the Philistine had what? Dominion over Israel." Verse 5. "Then went Samson down and his father and his mother to Timnath, and came to the vineyard of Timnath. And behold, a young, daring, white lion, as they came to the vineyard of Timnath, and behold, a young lion roared against him. And the Spirit of the Lord came mightily upon him, and he rent him as he would have rent a kid. And he had nothing in his hand, but he told his father or his mother what had done." Verse 7, I will be stopping verse 8. "And he went down and talked with the woman, and she pleased Samson well. And after a time, he returned to take her, and he turned aside to see the carcass of the lion. And behold, there was a swarm of bees and honey in the carcass of the lion. And he took therefore in his hand and went on eating, and came to his father and mother, and he gave them, and they did eat, but he told not them that he had taken the honey out of the carcass of the lion." May the Lord bless this word into our heart in Jesus' name. Yes, I want to bring to your way today a timely message that God put in my heart. I have meditated on this message, and I discovered that I need to come today to bring life, to bring hope to you once again. Because this world has gone into chaotic disorder. Things are no more, nowhere is safe in the world. You are on the air, it's not safe. You are in the land, it's not safe. You are in the sea, it's not safe. Everywhere, we hear bomb blasts, we hear plane crash, we hear war, everything. Israel just finished war lately, you know, with the enemy, with the Philistines, with the Palestine. Now, Everybody is at war. Whether you are at war in the realm of the spirit, you are at war in the physical. The way evil is on the loose is unprecedented. Is on the alarming rate. Evil is on the loose. Things are happening that people cannot even understand, cannot fathom what is really going on in the world. What is the end that is happening in the world? You see, now, there came a time in the life of Samson. Samson, the great man of God. People say Samson the strongest man. Samson is not really the strongest man. Jesus is the strongest man. With Jesus, you become strong. When the Holy Spirit is in you, you can do all things because he said, without me, you can do nothing. Now, a time came that Samson, follow me closely and the Lord is going to bless you with this message. If you are discouraged today, power to encourage you is going to come upon you with this timely message today. Because it's a message the Lord put in my heart and I'm out today to deliver it to you, to empty it. Because I feel something so great upon me right now. Because I know the Spirit of the Lord is moving with this message. I know there are countless number of people that are down and down, that are discouraged. Many have, they've refuriated themselves up. They've even concluded they can't walk again. Why am I existing? Why am I alive? Why am I here? Why did God create me? Many have concluded on themselves. But there is a hope, there is life, there is power that is coming upon you today. And you are going to appreciate the fact that you are alive today to follow this life message. Samson saw a woman. And when Samson saw a woman, and the Bible said that Samson went to his father, he went to his mother and told them that I found a woman in Timnah. He said, now follow me to go and take this woman for wife. Initially, the father and the mother, they were against him because they felt that was a strange woman. And they queried Samson and said, why did you not marry among your people? But they didn't know that this was of the Lord. Because when God wants to do something, he's the one that used the wicked thing of the earth to confirm the wise. God does not think the way men think. God does not does his things the way we do our own. God walks in a way you and I cannot understand. The Bible says the ways of the Lord are past finding out, and who can know it? Then the father finally succumbed to the pressure of Samson, because Samson persisted. The more they resisted the word of Samson, the more Samson insisted that they must go. Then they finally followed Samson and they were going. That was the day of Samson's happiness. The day was going to marry. The day was going to take a wife. The day that he would call a great day in his life. But he never knew that the enemy were planning another evil, another disaster. Hear me and hear me good. Whatever thing that is happening today, God is aware of it. And anything that happened to you as a child of God, the Bible says we should give God thanks in everything. God knows why those things, nothing happen without the awareness of God. Maybe this one happened, that one happened, that God is not aware. God is aware. If God is aware of everything that happened to you, then you need to be glad that if God can be aware of what I'm going through, which means he has not left me alone. Which means that same God is still with me. So that is everything about God. He's aware of it. He said, don't be worried. He said, look at the birds of the air. They don't sow, neither do they reap. They don't have planting season, the birds. They don't have to go to farm to plant or to reap. The Bible says, but your heavenly Father still feed them. Then he said, the hairs that are your head, they are all numbered. And no one falls to the ground without the awareness of this Almighty God. Which means, at the numbers of the hair on your head, God knows the number. And if hair that is not so important, and the Bible says, no one falls to the ground that God is not aware of, which means, if God can take notes, if God can be aware, if God can be so concerned about the hair that fell from your head, how about your life? He said, "Even your earthly father that is evil, you cannot ask him for bread and he give you stone. Your earthly father that is evil, you cannot ask him for fish and he give you serpent or scorpion. It's how much more your heavenly father." Now, while they were going to Timnah to go and take a wife, I'm telling you, the day of your happiness, the enemy has plan B. The day of your breakthrough, you must not just live your life anyhow. You must not just live a life without a purpose. You must understand nothing good in life comes easily. Whenever there is good thing that is coming your way, the enemy will fight it. That is why at times there is delay. And delay does not mean denial. The Bible says in Romans 8:28, it says, "For all things will work together for your good, because you love God. For to them that love God," hear this, "to them that love God, and to them that are called according to his purpose." As long as you keep on loving God, things will begin to work for your good. As long as you keep on loving God, God begins to turn the bad, the good, and the ugly to be in your favor. I see everything turning around for your good. That bad situation is turning around for your good. That evil situation, God is making it to favor you. It is not over until it is over. Then they took their journey and they went to Timnah. As they got to the fire where this girl lives, they had to pass a kind of a certain place, a street. While they pass the street and get to the cover of this girl, there is a pathway they had to pass while they got to Timnah. Ladies and gentlemen, as they got here, then there was a young devil lion, white lion, who was hidden somewhere, who was in a place. Nobody could see him. Then the father of Samson passed through the place. The lion did not respond. There were no response from the lion. Then the mother passed through the place. The lion did not attack. The lion still stayed cool and was watching for the main person. Why was it that the father passed there? The lion couldn't attack the father. Why was it that the mother passed through there? The lion couldn't attack the mother. But the time Samson was about to pass, and as he was crossing to go to the copper of this girl that he fell in love with, of this young, beautiful girl, then the Bible said the lion came out. Why is it that as Samson had been going through that road to go and see that girl, at least they must have they caught for some time. You know, Samson used to pass there, but the lion couldn't attack. But the day was going to marry. That was the day the father even passed. Because the father was not the one that was carrying the mantle. The mother was not the one that was carrying the assignment. The reason why the enemy are so bad about you is because you are the one that is carrying the message and the assignment. That was why the lion could not attack the mother. He could not attack the father. But as Samson was passing, then the lion came, a wild, you know, roaring lion came upon Samson. And the Bible said, when the lion came upon Samson, then the spirit of the Lord came upon him. Because it is written that when the enemy shall come like a flood, then the spirit of the Lord will raise up a standard against the enemy. Whatever that have come against you, the world may be loose upon you. Air might be let loose against you. I don't want you to give up. It is because there is something that is so unique about you that other people doesn't have. The reason why this battle is becoming so fierce is because you are almost arriving at your destination. It's because you are assigned to fulfill an assignment. It's because you are not just an ordinary person, a new person. You are somebody that has been ordained. You are somebody that has been blessed. You are somebody that has been called by God to save your generation, to save your family. You are the Joseph of your family. That is why everybody is against you. That is why every creature is against you. Because the father passed through that road as they go to Timnah, as they want to get to the compound of the girl. The father passed through, entered the compound. The lion never responded. Then the mother passed through. The lion never responded. Then when Samson, the man with the mission, the man with the mandate, the divine credibility, divine ordination, the one that has been validated by the Holy Spirit to save his generation for God, as he was about to cross, the lion came upon him. Because while if something were able to be conquered, which means generation yet unborn, they would have suffered and wallowed in pains and in darkness. Because Samson was carrying something. He was carrying divinity. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. Samson was carrying divine mandate to set free the children of Israel who were in captivity. That was why the lion came against him. Because the lion saw there are generations yet unborn that were going to be saved through Samson. Then when the lion came against Samson, he had a chapter. The Bible said, then all of a sudden, the Spirit of the Lord came mightily upon him. Ladies and gentlemen, when the enemy comes against you, that is when the Spirit of God is at his best. You might just be going and you might think you are just an ordinary person, that maybe there's no power that is covering you. Let them come against you. That is when you know that they that are with you are more than they that are against you. I come in the name of the Lord. You will not give up. They cannot destroy you because your destiny is in God's hand. Because one with God is with majority. If God be for us, no one can be against us. Let the whole head, let it be let loose. Because God is with you, they cannot bring you down. Because God is on your side. Power is on your side. He is the same God yesterday. He is the same God today. He is the same God forever. When God lifts you up, no one can bring you down. When God blesses you, no one can curse you. When God is on your side, miracle is on your side. When God is on your side, solution is on your side. When God is on your side, power is on your side. I decree today, anyone that has been conquered, anyone that has done, that has been abastered or approved by the devil, I come by the grace of the Almighty God. I come by the oil of God upon my life to set the captives free. Today, anyone in captivities, I declare you are free. By this usher and by this anointing upon my life today, those of you that are down, let your enemy begin to see you up. Those of you that are almost giving up, I see God working new things in your life. He is not a God that will lie. Never the Son of Man that he should repent. If he says it, he will bring it to pass. If he says it, he will bring it to pass. That is why they called him the same God of Abraham. If he did it for Abraham, he will do it for you. The God of Isaac. If he did it for Isaac, he will do it for you. The God of Jacob, if he did it for Jacob, he will do it for you. Then when the lion came against Samson, the Spirit of the Lord comes upon him. This battle does not belong to you. This battle belongs to the Lord. Exodus 14:14, he said, this battle you need not to fight. He said, hold your peace. Hold your peace. This battle belongs to God. God will fight this battle for you. Very soon I see you getting to the top. Very soon I see you getting at the mark. And very soon I see you making it. Very soon I see you, those people that have rejected you coming to you to call you. Those people that have laughed you, that have written you off, I see them coming to you and say, we are very sorry. The lion caught on Samson, and the Spirit of the Lord came upon Samson. And the Bible says, Samson tore the young lion. Samson tore the dreaded lion. Samson tore the dreaded beast. And Samson tore it to pieces. This was the lion that came upon him the day of his marriage. Why did the lion come upon him the day of his marriage? Because he knew that was his happiest day. He knew that was a great day of his celebration. He knew that was a day of a turning around in his life. That was why they wanted to destroy him. That was why they wanted to silence him. They didn't want him to experience a turnaround in life. But God, who have called me and you, is not asleep. If God be for us, no one can be against us. Samson turned the lion into pieces by the power of God, by the grace of God upon his life. Because if God calls you, he will sustain you. If God calls you, he will be with you. If you are a child of God, he will not allow evil to come upon you. If you are a child of God, he will not allow the enemy to destroy you. Because as you are serving God faithfully and God allowing it to destroy you, with me is an indictment. It becomes indictment on God's part that God could not save his own. God, he will be able to save you even to the uttermost part. God is able to save you even to the end. The Bible said that God will take off you even to the days of Christ, and the lion died. Ladies and gentlemen, the Bible said, after the death of the lion, the father and the mother never knew what happened. That Samson spent some little time before he joined them, that it was a lion that came upon him to kill him. But Samson defeated the lion. Samson destroyed the lion. Then he finally reunited with the parents while they were in the house of the woman. He finally married the woman. Oh my God, they meant it for evil, but he was able to marry the wife. They meant it for evil. They want to stop you. There's nothing bad for them to come against you, for them to say you can't succeed, but don't fail to show them your success. There is nothing bad for them to say you cannot rise up. As when Jesus died, the Bible said they concrete, they cemented his grave so that he cannot resurrect. But the third day, Jesus still resurrected. Let me tell you today that today they succeeded on you. You are still struggling because it's the first day. Today they are still rejoicing. They are still laughing at you because it's the second day. The third day, I see you rising up. Your third day is coming. Your third day is coming. Your day of supremacy. Your day of victory. Your day of fulfillment. Your day of no more battle. That is your third day. Then Samson took the wife back home. Ladies and gentlemen, the white beast that wanted to kill Samson, after about 2-3 days, Samson went to go and see the white beast, the lion. Behold, do you know what Samson saw? Can I give you the shock of the century? Now, Samson saw on top of the bone of the lion that wanted to kill him, there were an honey bees, and the bees have already formed honey. Hear me, church, that was the animal, that was the white beast, lion, that wanted to kill Samson. But out of the bone, there were honey. Ah, Magadayana Dabayanaya. Hey, Kelebro Dosege Bregedeske. What want to kill you? There is a seed of blessing inside. All you don't need to do is to be able to overcome it. It's not to give up. Because a quitter never win, and a winner never quit. No matter how you tell it, God will not allow shame to come upon you. God shall deliver you from shame and reproach. No matter those that have laughed at you, they are coming back to laugh with you. Ah, Sarah said, at my old age, God has made me to laugh. I see God making you to laugh again. It's not how long, it's how well. Your God is alive. Samson saw honey on top of the carcass of the lion, the bone of the lion. There were honey. What wanted to kill him? And the Bible said, Samson took off the honey, and Samson licked, and he gave to his parents, and the parents also licked from the honey. And Samson went home. My God, the reason why God spared you, there are generations that you are going to put honey in their life. The reason why God spared you, there are your younger ones that you are going to put happiness in their life. Samson took off the honey, they begin to lick it. What want to kill him? How come there will be honey on the bone of the lion? That is what God can do. Those things they meant for evil for you can be made for your promotion. Every stone that is thrown at you, you can use that stone as a stepping stone. You don't need to give up. You don't need to quit. What you are going through, the problem you are going through, the cases you are going through, there is a seed of solution. See the hand of God in it. You are going to, there is a light at the end of the tunnel. You are going to come out successfully. You are going to come out with joy. You are going to come out with great substance. When you come out, God will begin to announce you to the world. What can you see, my son? God will display you, because he said we are seated with Christ on the heavenly places. We are no more on this earth. Our level has left this earth. Where we are, the Bible says, is far above principalities and power. No principality can get to you. The speed you have given to witches and wizards is too far. The distance between you and failure is so great that you cannot fail. You cannot fail your generation. You cannot fail your people. You cannot fail your community. You cannot fail your city, because there is something great in you. There is an army that God has given to you that you must give to the people. There is something sweet you must put in the life of people whose life is bitter. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. He took the honey, get to experience. He became, you know, an instrument of blessing to his family. He gave the parents the honey, and the father looked. And the Bible said, Samson also did well in verse 9. And he took therefore of his hand and went and his mother, and he took thereof in his hand and went on eating, and came to his father and mother, and he gave them, and they did eat. And he told them then, he told not them that he had taken the honey out of the carcass of the lion. He gave of the honey to his father, to his mother. Because he was the only son, there were no other children, but I wasn't giving to other children. That was the lion that wanted to kill him. There is a seed of solution in that problem that you are going through. There is honey inside you, don't give up. The end of it, if only you can survive it, if only you can trust God, you can believe God, God is going to use you. He's going to use that situation to announce you to the world. He's going to use that situation to give you speed. Because every trial you went through, there is a double blessing for it. May the Lord bless you. This is the timely word from God. Your life cannot be the same anymore. Don't give up. Well, yes, it's true. Pastor, you can say, Pastor, this thing I'm going through is so much. Yes, it's true. God designed it. Because the bigger the problem, the bigger your victory and testimony. The bigger what you are going through, the bigger the joy and the greatness that God is there for you. It is well for you. It is well with you. Please, this same time next week, I will also be with you live. I will be coming with God's timely message that is also going to bless you. Remain blessed. Remain blessed. Please, next week, we will be together. You can also share to your friends this same message. Those of friends that are not opportune to worship, share to them and let this also be a blessing to them. The Lord will bless you. In Jesus' name, amen.